publicize this on November, in the record, on Thursday, May 23rd, and it went in Sunday. So just please be advised that it was publicized that way. And with that, I'd like to call the meeting to order. Just so everyone knows, the people that haven't been here, there are three exits. There's one in the back there, one out through that door, the main entrance that you came in, and down that hallway. The bathrooms are also down that hallway on the left-hand side. I'm going to introduce Sari, and she's going to introduce the her board. I wanted to address that we have our two chairmen here from the zoning and planning board, and we have the members of the boards here in the first and second row. So with that, I'll turn it over to China City of America, and they're going to do it's a presentation. It's an informal presentation so that we can see what they are proposing. This is partial in town of Thompson and town of Mamakating, so there's two towns involved with this. I do ask everyone to turn your cell phones off, put it on vibrate, whatever we need, so that they can present their project to us, and then we'll proceed with that, and we'll go through that. See, she's been ready to turn her phone off.
Yes, I do listen. Okay. First of all, thank for Harold, the Thompson supervisor, Tom Mamakating supervisor, to giving us opportunity to present our project here in Mamakating. And I want to give a brief introduction of my team. Behind me here is Johnny. He's one of our partner. And Jose is our construction manager. And Liambo at the back is our marketing director. And Tim is from Keystone Associates, our architecture firm. And Ken is a partner of the Keystone. So we have our member, the team here. And we are very happy to go over our project with everybody here today. What we are going to do is we're going to do similar like we did in Thompson, and we're still going to using the brochure which speaks some words. So first of all, go to this book. With this book, and we will try to make it really brief, go over what we plan to do.
Do you have any more of those books?
We today will only bring the books for the town boards, and we will provide more documentation for the town, and you're welcome to go to the town. We will provide a lot more there. So starting with this page, the initial page is basically showing our feng shui concept. What is feng shui concept? Feng means air, shui means water. So given that feng shui is air and water, that's basically we care about the air, we care about the water, and which create positive energy for our lifestyle, for our living style. When we go to this page, that's what we propose to, we plan to do for the site A, which is more like an amusement park type of project. When we go to the center here, it's going to be our China concept for with our 5,000 years old of the history. We have about 60 major dynasties. So for each dynasty, we're going to have that dynasty's style construction building. It will be like a gift shop. And we'll also have the rides to go with it. And in the central area, we're going to, this page is kind of like the ideal animation of it, but it's not the final animation. In the central area, it's 12 zodiacs. Like we're all born in different years. Like this year is a snake year. Some people born in dragon year. So there are 12 circles. So each zodiac will have its own rides and shopping building with it. And right outside there's another circle. We call it the 28 horoscope sign. That's basically how Chinese view of the universe where the stars lies in. So with this, in the middle, it's a Forbidden City type of building. It's going to be the shows, events, and exhibitions, dances, all that. So this entire center here is basically the spirit of how Chinese view the universes and also contains our 5,000 years of culture. When we go to the more southwest part, it's what we call it the 56 ethnic park. Chinese has 56 ethnics or nationalities. They all have their own different clothes and dances and culture and gifts. So, you know, in this area, we are going to basically put different ethnics as clothes and gifts and dancing and shows and even some of their food and other stuff. To be here. When we go to back on the east side here, what we call is the Chinese sports park, also can call the martial arts or Kung Fu park, which we can put the Shaolin temple, Kung Fu shows, or karate, so with all these traditional Chinese Kung Fu, so, I mean, especially for kids in the summertime, they want to learn these moves and get practiced. Under here, it's what we call the Four Famous Novel Park. The Chinese have four famous historical novels. One is well-known, like the Monkey King's stories, and another one is the Three Kingdoms. There's also another story, it's talking about 108 Good Parents. That's all good amusement, the same for people to learn the culture. And with all this Chinese culture, we are going to develop the cartoon stories, and there will be characters and the gifts, everything associated with the Chinese culture. So this site is what we call the site A, and there will be a reserved spot. We haven't finally decided what we're going to develop yet at this point. That's down the road. So this will be mainly for the Chinese culture scene, amusement park side. When we go to the site B, it's on the north side of the Route 17. It's between 112 and 111, which this picture shows exactly where the lot or spot is, which those properties are basically commercial. And residential parts we want to put in to go with our China City concept. On this part, there is 222 acres of IO zonings, lots. And we're going to put two concepts there. One concept is what we're going to call headquarters centers. For example, we are going to diversify it to different industry. We'll say, okay, this building is the medical equipment building. The other building is the IT building. Another building is the textile building. So the companies from China wanted to have their business in the United States belong to that industry, can get their offices or showroom of that specific building. And this, because we're going to do our entire online promotion with their product or services link, and we promote our entire China City to the United States. And when US companies or customers looking for any Chinese businesses, they kind of can use that as a guideline to find these companies. On the right hand side is another concept we call 36 province exhibition hall. Instead of using the industry as the index, we use it, the 36 province exhibition hall is basically, we diversified the showrooms to be more like the geographically, for each province, Shandong province or Shanxi province, each of them have, let's say, 10,000 square feet, and companies from that region or that location allowed to put their showrooms or products and things over there. And in the central area will be taller, probably, let's say, 20 feet high or 25 feet high exhibition center in the area for some exhibition and conventional shows for different businesses from China. And we are going to have a little cultural sidewalk go with it, and that's going to be more like a retail stores and the storefronts and coffee store, restaurants, basically will serve for those people who living here or people who work here or having their business lunch with the visitors also. And on the last page here, we have residential zoning, which is on the east side, on the west side of the Route 56. That's all residential zoning. We basically plan to do Chinese courtyard style houses and the western style houses. We will have a certain amount of houses which are relatively larger, probably 4,000, 6,000 square feet. And there will be a number of smaller residential houses, probably 1,800 to 3,500 square feet, smaller houses. We will have a hotel apartments. And in the project, we are going to build our own school system. We are going to have our own senior center and medical center and even the maternity, mother and child care center. And this original plan was basically a concept. As we join the later site plan, we already know the land better, we know where the slopes are and wetlands are. So the layout over there already changed a little bit from our original concept. So, giving a brief, this basically is our China City project.
Okay, Scott or Gary, you have any questions that you would like to ask?
The offices and stuff, are they open in the restaurants? Are they open to the public, or is that?
Yes, all our restaurants, offices, and the showrooms, and even the stores of our amusement park side are open to public. We allow any business to come in to purchase or leasing from us. We allow any customer, any client, whenever come to us.
Access to the site, where do you plan on bringing the traffic into? Yankee Lake Lot 8 plan?
At this meeting, we're still just doing the conceptual level, and we have the professional teams going to continue to work on to give the develop the actual plans with the town and to find out the best solutions for everything.
John?
Have you already purchased all the lands, or all the lands owned by your corporation?
We had the land under contract. We paid the money put in the escrow account. The diligence period, we're going to study the land, and after we completed our due diligence, and also after our final approval completed with the USCIS, we're going to close the land.
I'm concerned about the water and septic. That this seems like it's going to be a humongous project, and you know, I guess it's too early to say whether it's going to be long yet, but just.
We are at the initial stages of our planning. Today is just here to present our project. We have professional teams who work along with the town to develop this plan. I want to give a little bit input of what our groups are and what our philosophies are to show everybody our idea. This picture here is one of the poster my son drew after the April 22nd, and his birthday is April 22nd. So there was a every day is the Earth Day event in New York State. So my son drew this with my help, but it's his own creative thought. He put here, my birthday is on Earth Day, and he drew the Earth, and he put the preserved water here, and growing the trees, and save paper, and recycle the bottles, recycle the plastic bags, and he put here reuse, recycle, and April 22nd, 2007 to 2013. He did receive an award from the Senator Carl Marcelillo, which is fifth sensational district, and he's the only one in his school receiving this. So this shows, you know, our family love to give the earth, we love the earth, that's how we educate our son. And I'm also a rural life style lover ourselves. This is our house. I have 6 acres. And this is the side of the garden. My son has his tree house there. And a few weeks ago, we found a bird come to a bird family come to our tree house, made a nest there, and they lay out 4 blue eggs. Those are the American ribbon. And this morning, I went up there. They all hatched. And look at this, mommy, I'm hungry. So this is in our backyard. And this is our backyard, the other side. We have a lot of trees. There's a fox family living our forest here. There are bunny rabbits. There are turtles. There are snake and frog. And there are also raccoons. We catched him 3 times and he still go to that same cage. So just show you we are the environmental lover and want to protect the earth. And to give a little brief about our partner here. This is one of our funding partners, which is called the Bodrum Carbon Fund. And this article we put on New York Times last September 14th. This is our article we put there, is environmental protection, take action now. I mean, I'm gonna skip everything, I'm just gonna put it to the back. It says, we must do all our share of protecting the future of our planet. Together we can make a better world for all of us and the future generation. We donate a lot of trees to one of the provinces in China, and we create a lot of jobs locally. So basically, we invest in Western China through the carbon forestry enlargement and help poor people out of poverty while improving the environment that we all must share and live with. So basically, this is our concept and philosophy. We wanted to create economic development while also promoting to provide protect the environment.
What percentage is in Mamakating of the total project?
Well, I said, well, my regional center does allow me to do my project in multiple county, a lot of multiple county in the Pennsylvania. I like Salem County, it sounds beautiful, and we would love to work with the towns who have our same philosophy, promoting the economy and protecting the environment. If any town supports us bigger, we would love to invest there, invest with them and build a beautiful future with them again.
Do you want to know what percentage of the town we were
taking? Yeah, of the acres.
How many acres? It's basically roughly two-thirds.
Yeah.
Acres, I don't.
Yeah, two-thirds of the acres.
You know, you enumerated some of the gains for the people in this town. But how, you know, enumerate, you know, what are the benefits for Mamakating? Bringing thousands of new people in.
We pay taxes for the properties, and we're going to build our own schools. We're going to have our own road services and fire departments, and we're going to build our own schools. We are welcome for the town people to come to our school. We are going to bring very top teachers.
You're aware that you're building into an area that we designate as the Mountain Green Belt.
I have to bring you to.
And guys, could you hold it down so we can everybody can hear? Thank you. So
could you recap and repeat more? I'm sure question. I don't think everybody heard.
No, I didn't either. More. I'm down here.
I think I'm going to switch it to Ken, our architecture engineer, to answer more questions. Thank you.
Do we want to start back at the question?
Please. Could you repeat the
What are the benefits for the people who live in this town? Because you have to realize that you're changing the whole complexion of the town from a rural town to one that I would consider high density urban development. And how do we overlay one on the other and say, well, the people who live in Mamakating are going to be a net gainer from this?
I think that's a very good question. It's a fair question. Obviously, there's not been a great deal of planning that has gone into this yet. The concept plan has come from Sherry's concept in Chinese development, and we're learning it as we go ourselves. I think some of the features that I've been told will exist is this is a taxable project. Everything is taxable. We're not looking for any help from outside the area. The roads are private for them. The utilities are private. We're hoping that we're going to be able to upgrade some of the facilities, some of the roads, some of the features that you have there now. So I think that's going to be a benefit. And you've listened to Sherry, and although it's sometimes it's hard to understand the concepts that she's bringing across, she is very much interested in keeping a rural development, even though this density seems a little high. It is following your zoning code correctly right now. The density is the same as if you had done a conventional subdivision here. So it's just shaped oddly when you come up and see this, odd to us, I should say, because a lot of the homes are in a circle. And I've done this kind of work for a long time, and I've not done circle roads before, so I'm learning how this happens. So it's not our intent to come in here and take everything down and wipe everything out. It's our intent to try to blend in with the environment. As you probably all know with this kind of development, there is a long process for environmental review and public input, and we're welcoming that. We've purposely not gone anywhere as far as a design capacity yet because we felt that would be wrong at this point. We need a lot of input, and we'll see where it goes. We're willing to invest a lot of money in the town, and I'm sure there's benefits that I'm not even thinking about.
Well, you're aware the population of our town is, what, about 9,000 people?
It's 12.
12,000 people. And the population that you're talking about bringing in, what is it, roughly 1,000 housing units?
Yeah, it's approximately 1,000 households.
And the average density of a housing unit in our town, I think, is 3.4. Depends upon the bedrooms that you're going to put in. So you're talking about increasing the population of Mamakating between 30% and 40%.
Yeah, significant, sure.
Just to touch on that really quickly, we're also bringing a lot of jobs to the town of Mamakating. One of our main objectives is to bring and work with the local townspeople, local subcontractors, which know the land, they know the local, and we're looking to follow. We're looking to follow and not disturb you, keep it in line as much as possible. And my main priority, our main priority, is to make sure that we work together with you guys. Benefits for the town, we're bringing, yes, a lot of people, but also think about how much money is coming to the town, where it's going to help you down the road. Job.
So we can, everybody can hear. Anybody else here?
No, I'm good.
Good. Bill?
Sure. Is there any, there's rumors, so let's dispel rumors. Has China City developed anywhere else, and what kind of success did you have there?
I will say our China City, if we make it in a simpler level, it's like a Chinatown. There has been tremendous Chinatown has been developed all over the United States. A lot of them are successful. What I want to say is with this new generation of immigration, it's most of the family are very highly educated, and they are affluential. And you can see we are the group of Chinese people who wanted to make a difference. If I refer to that advertising equipment here, you can see we are the group of Chinese people promoting the environmental protection, and our goal is to promote the economy meanwhile protect the environment. And our partners also building a low carbon immune or zero carbon immune senior community in China. So that's basically our goal is. We are not there to try to destroy any nature we have, just like my background, like what I teach myself.
That wasn't the question, though. That was a good answer, but it was not to the question I asked. The question I'm asking is, and I'll be more specific, have you developed before, and have you developed, or has anybody developed a China city of Australia, Detroit, or Florida?
Well, if we call it Chinatown, there has been so many people devoted to China. Nothing exactly like what I developed it. I'm higher level. We input the culture and the environmental protections into the project.
Is this the first project you're doing?
No, we've done amusement park project in China, and I've done residential development in Lion.
Not a project
you think
has ever been developed anywhere in the United States.
John?
Hey, thanks for being here tonight. I'm wondering, the residential portion, the houses, what, are those in Mamakating or are those in Thompson?
Both.
And then I'm also aware that in Splendid China, back in the 90s, there was a Chinese theme park that was constructed that was a $100 million project and ultimately went out of business. And I'm wondering what you think is different about the environment now.
This is a very good question, sir. I think like what the community community want us to know what community needs. Just like anybody else in the world, people also, investor also wanted to invest with people who know what they need. Okay, the project we're talking about in year 90, the developer hasn't considered market need at all. Back then, Chinese culture is not popular. The market is not there. Last year, Chinese language became the number one selected language in the U.S. colleges and schools. The first time exit Spanish as a second language people, family wanted their children to learn. So right now, Chinese culture is at a different stage. There are a lot of American families all the world want their children be able to learn multiple cultures, especially China, to be able to be competitive. So that's number one reason I think we are in a different market type. And not by just saying that, we've done a lot of our homework. In these two books, it's a letter of interest. The families and business wanted to purchase the offices or the houses and apartments from us. Without all the letter of interest, once we have the working permit, people will start to buy and start investing. Look at this book. The first section I have here is called the China Business Associations, the first sector. All these are large business associations. Each of them will have about minimum 20,000 member firms of that industry, and the largest one has 6.5 million member firms association. They all sign up waiting to bring their member firms to do business here. That's what we know. We have to know what the people's need is, market need is. I mean, the most of the EB5 original center failed. Basically, two major reasons. Number one, lack of business or economic sense. Number two, don't consider any of Chinese EB5 investors' need. All the projects I look at, they don't care what EB5 investors want. Do they care about them? Do we care about them? Yes, we do. That's why we have the market. I have these people, I have the market before I even have a land, before I even have a permit. And we can find thousands of projects here, have the working permit, have the land, find no investors. You know what? They don't know what people need. They don't know what people want. That's the reason why they fail.
I noticed that you have a future casino plan for Yankee Lake. If New York State doesn't approve of you guys getting a casino, would you even consider going ahead with this project?
Like we said in our last presentation in Thompson, our project can be success with or without a casino. We do have a feasibility study done by the local feasibility report. This is the feasibility report. This is among the other 5,000 pages we sent it to the U.S. CIS for our regional center approval back a year and a half ago. We started preparing all this document 2 years ago. Okay, this is a local feasibility study indicating our project can succeed with or without casino project. This report also indicates we'd be able to generate 1.5 million visitors annually, just as our China City project alone. Another book we can show you is the job impact study. Our job impact study is done by the number one national job impact firm. If everybody goes to this page, which we haven't told you last time, this is part of our professional teams. Our job impact study was done by the Economic Policy Resources. This is the number one U.S. job impact study firm which have been prepared over 50% of the regional center's job impact study. The model, the job creation code they created is following the USCIS code, is following what the government has set up, and shows us for the center part, this part alone can create 3,000 direct and indirect jobs. And given that, the jobs, USCIS normally giving about 3 to 4 years job creation. There will be partial of the job is a construction job. After the construction period finished, 3 years down the road, those jobs no longer exist. But there will be long-term job existing, including the service jobs. The people who work in the stores in the amusement park, and the maintenance people, and the nurseries people for this project. So for the multiple project, we are confident we can say we should be able to maintain. Every project alone should create a few thousand direct and indirect jobs itself. But some of the job after the construction finish, the job is no longer exists probably after 2-3 years when the construction job is done. But there will be long-term job existing. We are confident to say with all the projects, if we build them all, and the other side of the project, we should have long-term about minimum 5,000 jobs to create to the local community.
A couple of quick questions. Is the project broken up into several different parts, or is it constructed as one whole project?
It's phases.
Could you go through which phases
and up like an area?
Most likely, we are going to do this set B, meaning everything here. Because a lot of the initial studies, for example, traffic study and the water supply study and some other studies has been initially completed. So we are working together with our professional teams to get our package together. So the site A, we are doing our due diligence. We are studying the land. We do think we are going to develop that further down the road. The initial one will be just residential houses and some recent.
So residential houses would be first.
Yes.
And then more commercial entities later. Provide more taxes, more jobs would be later.
Yeah.
Would the houses be available to any resident?
Yes. Why? Yes, any resident.
Anything else from the board?
Have you done any studies there to determine wetlands locations on the residential area to develop, wetlands?
What we have, and when you have a chance to come up and look at the map, the concept plan that we prepared, it was prepared based on the wetland study that was done back in 2008. So we used that information. We used survey information from 2008, and then we stayed away from steep slope areas, and that's kind of how that was developed through that area.
And that the zone for the residential area, is that Mount Loop out there?
It fit into the zoning category as we have it on here.
And then
correct,
you did
the density.
And density, you use possibly slope density to come
correct
up with the...
Correct, with the amount of homes, correct.
I got a question about the medical center you proposed in Lot B. Would there be an emergency room that would be accessible to residents of Mamakating?
Yes. We would love to share this fire department, police, or medical center with the local community to provide any help we can.
Okay. We're going to close the meeting. They've agreed to basically stay and come up, look at the maps. They'll take questions one on one for anybody, including the public. Let's not make a bob scene. Just please wait your turn. Take your turn. There's a lot more information that we all have to collect. This is strictly at a starting stage of someone, looking at our town. So please just, encourage everybody to keep an open mind, learn. I'm in the learning stages, and I think everybody on all our boards are. So again, I want to thank everyone for being courteous to them, and I want to make a motion to adjourn. Okay, all in favor? Thank you, everyone.